teach about Jiu Jitsu is like I like to focus more on concept, right? Because if we focus too much on technique, the guy moves 1 inch and the whole rule of the game changes if you base on technique. If you focus on the concept, then now when the guy makes the adjustment, you can adapt, you can adjust that. Does everybody understand what I'm talking about? I remember when I was like, I don't know, man, I think I was like 8 or 9 years old, and I made a bad choice at home. And I remember just like today, you know, my dad said, you know, son, my job is to teach you right and wrong. It's your job to do the right thing. And that, I was 9 years old, and I made a conscious decision of doing something wrong and whatever it was. I think it was actually I ate my sister's food. I had my piece, my sister had half of the her meal, ate, and then it was a big mess. And obviously not about the food, but, and I remember my dad, he's like, listen, my job is serving you right and wrong, but if you choose wrong, you're gonna have to deal with the consequence. Mm-hmm. And that really stuck for me forever. It's like, you know, it's like my job is not tell you, don't do this, don't do that, because otherwise there's so much don't that your phone is gonna be on the don't, that's impossible for you to make the right decision. Okay, so it really helped in my life, and I really try to apply that in Jiu-Jitsu. Okay, so the best way to learn Jiu-Jitsu, I believe, is reverse engineering. Okay, so if I have a clue on my on the side body, I had the exact weight, and I'm on the side body. I cannot really get on the side body, but clue is a little bit sideways. And though clue is pushing my face here, right? This is what? This is not fun. Are you guys understanding what I'm talking about? Dude, this is not fun. No, nobody likes that another man's face on your another man's hand on your face. You know? But the truth is, the real issue is the what? What is the real issue? Is the elbow on the ground. Why? Because if I cut the elbow on the ground, he can't shrink. So he can push, I can keep pushing. But it's just a matter of time that I'm gonna wiggle in and out. That's how I'm getting that disposition all the time. You guys understand? That's how I get all the time. A lot of times I cup your elbow and I let you put your hand on my face, I push it, and I cup here, boom. And that's how I get that side body pressure. But really, are you guys understanding or not? And if you don't, I'm about to roll like, if you're gonna do a few more rolls, I'll make sure you're gonna figure it out. But The impressive thing is because it's so much pressure, right? So much pressure that you literally feel like tapping. You know, if you really feel like that, no, if you think I hold, you're gonna have to tap. Because if you put the weight on the diaphragm the right way, it's like you really feel like an anaconda. You know? So, but the thing is, because he is so overwhelmed with the pressure that he doesn't realize the key is what? Is this here, this elbow. As long as I have this elbow, I can keep pushing here, and I keep here, right here, keep pushing me to the right. But I'm here, I'm gonna, because there's so much pressure on him, he keep relying on this head here, oh, but I'm keeping the elbow here. And I, a lot of times I even do here, oh, but I almost like make a face like this is bugging me. So he rely even more on this push, and the more he push, the tighter, the deeper I can get on his back. I guess what I'm talking about or no? John's not really understanding. We're gonna roll next door. You guys understand what I'm talking about or no? That's the reason why we drill and come up on the elbow and all of that. We're gonna keep working a lot of this come up on the elbow. Okay? Now, the way I like to teach you this is the reverse engineering, right? So if my feet is my hand, my knee is my elbow. Can you guys understand what I'm talking about? Everything that applies from my arms will apply to my legs in some degree. Are you guys understanding or not? So when I pass his guard, the issue is I pass his guard. Are you guys understand what I'm talking about or not? So the leg is not really a challenge anymore. Obviously he can get the leg back, he can pass the leg over and all that. But really, when I pass his leg, I need to control what? His arm. I guess I understand what I'm talking about. If I control his arm, good, he's not going anywhere.